Continue with our intro to the day from Psalm 98. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder.
And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
O sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things.
His right hand is before his own arm, and the word of salvation in our hand.
The Lord has made known his salvation. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth.
Bring forth into joyous songs and sing praises.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder.
And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here and in their homes their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
for he has done marvelous things.
The epistle reading is from the first chapter of Hebrews. Long ago, at many times and in many ways, God spoke to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed the heir of all things, through whom also he created the world. He is the radiance of the glory of God and the exact imprint of his nature, and he upholds the universe by the word of his power. After making purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, today I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son"? And again, when he brings the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all God's angels worship him." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We rise for our verse, O come, O come, Emmanuel. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We confess our holy faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. Together we confess, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and
and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated for our next Christmas hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful. The lights that we have in the windows, to the extended candelabras, to the wreath of lights as the Advent wreath. It is a time for us to think about lights. Our text says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Right. Because the Christmas story is a story about, yes, that baby in a manger, but that baby in the manger wasn't just a baby, that baby in a manger is God incarnate. John goes on and says, he was in the beginning with God, all things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. And then four more times in our text today, St. John the Divine talks about the light, because Christmas is about light. It's about the one who was to say in his teaching ministry, "I am the light of the world," and it is the one who shines light upon a darkened place, but who also is here to give his children lights. Consider what Jesus says in Matthew chapter 5 in the Sermon on the Mount. He said, "You are the," what? "The light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden." And Paul writes in Ephesians 5, verse 8, "For you were once in darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children in the light." There's a Christmas banner that's hung up in the back that you probably saw on the way in. You might not have read all the words, but you probably noticed that it was there because it's got a beautiful manger, but it also has a shining star, and it says, "Come, Lord Jesus, shine through us." The Lord is light, and he has called us to also be lights. Not as he is light, because he is the true light that shines in the darkness, and he is the one light that comes and forgives people all of their sins, but nevertheless, we are called to shine forth. We are called to allow Jesus to shine forth in us. Consider, if you will, these kinds of lights, right? You're familiar with these kinds of lights. I got the extra large ones, so those of you in the back can see, right? These are Christmas lights, and you plug them in, but these are kind of old-fashioned. But because it's a string of lights, what often happens when one light goes out? I know! And then you say, "What happened?" And you look for the troublesome bulb, which maybe you'll find, maybe you won't find, but it makes a difference, right? With a string of lights, if there's something with one of the lights that isn't shining like it should. And I dare say it's like that in the church. God has called us together here in this place so that we might come together and be lights in our community. And we pray that the Lord would shine brightly forth in each and every one of us so that collectively people might see that we are the light that the Lord has called us to be. Today is a day of surprises, not only in our text, also in the weather. For those of you who are watching remotely, please know that it's already in the 50s here in beautiful Glens Falls. And I know, we still have snow, but that's only because we got 3 feet a little earlier. Otherwise, it would have all melted away. So it's kind of a Christmas that's different. And we have a different kind of song for us to sing. It's not a typical Christmas song, but it is a bonus because it is Christmas Day. Keep your masks on, but this has motions, okay? And it's not the kind of song that you might expect to sing on Christmas morning, and yet it is certainly a song that fits the occasion of Jesus, who is the light of the world, who has called us to be light. Okay, if you know it, join in. "This little light of mine," oh come on, you know this. "This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel." No! Yes! No, yeah, no, right. No, soft. "Hide it under a bushel." No! "I'm gonna let it shine." "Hide it under a bushel." No! "I'm gonna let it shine." "Hide it under a bushel." No! "I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine." Come, Lord Jesus, shine through us. May that be our prayer this day as we celebrate light coming in the world, into the world of darkness, but into our hearts and our lives and in our homes. In the name of Jesus, our light and our life, dear friends, amen. Amen. So we sing again. discuss, remember Ken Harris, who is in the hospital. He was undergoing tests yesterday, and if he hasn't already, will be undergoing a procedure. Please remember Ken in your prayers. Also, if you would remember Jim, Ken's brother-in-law, and Judy's brother, who is undergoing treatments at this time. We come before the Lord our God with our prayers and petitions. He promises that he listens to and answers the prayers of his people. Would you please rise? Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, on that first Christmas day, you brought light into the world. We pray that that light might continue to shine in our hearts. Lord, we thank you for the Christmas message. We thank you for the promise and hope that we have in Jesus. And we thank you for the light that we have in him who is the light of the world. May he enlighten our lives and guide us by the light of his love and his grace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, this day we pray for two of your servants who are ill. We ask that you would be with Ken and Jim, that you would guide those who are treating them and helping them in their time of great need. And we pray that you might grant them the gift of healing. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask this in all things, remembering the words that we were given to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way, also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please share some sign of the peace with the person you're with. Having shared the sign of the peace, we invite you to sit down. The ushers will bring you forward to receive the sacrament. Christ given for you. Take and drink the blood of Jesus shed for you. May our Lord's body and blood strengthen and keep you in the true faith to everlasting life. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Joining us for this service Christmas Day. We are an hour earlier and we're also a lot fuller than we typically are. So thank you for joining us here in person as well as for those who are joining us remotely. And today is a day of some surprises in terms of the weather, maybe in terms of the message, also in terms of something that you'll receive on the way out, a calendar, because we pray that next year will be much better than this present one. And we'll thank God for bringing us through some darker times through the light of His grace, but please accept this as a gift and as an added bonus for joining us here this Christmas morning. We rise for prayer. Let us pray. Almighty Father, in the incarnation of your Son, you brought light into a darkened world. Through the grace of this holy sacrament, strengthen us in spirit and renew us in a new birth we have through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us through the challenges of this year past. We thank you for being our light in times that sometimes were darkened. We pray that your light would continue to lead us in the new year to come, and we pray that you would heal our nation. We pray that you would heal our world, that you would heal our homes, and that you would heal our lives. Look upon us with mercy and grace, you who are our Lord, our Savior, our healer, and our help. We ask this in all things in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We sing our closing hymn.
Thank you. and we're better.